looking for? The word on the street. What's the word on the street? Spectacular. What is spectacular?
Like phenomenal and incredible.
Just the greatest thing ever.
Something very exciting.
What would you think is spectacular?
Dancing.
Dancing, yes.
A fireworks display? That could be spectacular.
Yeah, those are spectacular. Keep listening for the word spectacular. Today on Sesame Street. Spectacular. That's the word on the street. You know what I think is spectacular?
What, you?
Noticed, I'm taking a bath right now, and I'd like to finish taking it.
Okay.
In my apartment.
Oh, no problem. Let me just think of a magic spell.
Abby.
Yeah. I need something that rhymes with apartment.
Oh boy, that's hard.
Compartment. Department.
No, Gordon. I don't think those rhymes are gonna work.
Well. Abby, can you think of something else?
Okay. Let me see here. I got it. Okay. Gordon, rub-a-dub-dub, go back home and take your
Now what do we do?
Well, we wait for Gordon to come back.
But waiting is hard. All I want to do is ride my tricycle.
Yeah, maybe we should try and think of something else.
Like what?
Well, anything but tricycles.
Yeah.
Oh, how about marshmallows?
Okay, marshmallows.
Okay.
Marshmallows.
Oh, tricycle. Oh, boy.
That didn't work.
No, it didn't. Well, let's think of something else quick.
Okay.
So you can sit on the seat here.
Oh, here I come. Here I am. I'm sitting.
It's just a little uh-oh, Abby. You're facing the wrong way, that's all.
I'm sorry. I'm just a little excited.
Oh, tell Abby all about the tricycle, Gordon. Oh, the front and back part.
Well, Abby, the tricycle has a front and a back.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, Elmo loves that part.
See, the front has handlebars, one wheel, and one, two pedals.
Oh, handlebars, one wheel, and one, two pedals.
Right, and the back has one, two wheels, and no handlebars.
Okay, one, two wheels, and no handlebars.
God is the man.
So, go ahead and sit on the seat facing front.
Oh, okay.
Oh, good, Abby. How's this? I'm facing front, right?
That's right.
I'm facing front. Oh, I'm so excited.
Oh, there she goes again.
Come down, Abby. It's time to put your feet on the pedal.
Oh, boy.
Okay, here we go. Now, put one foot on this pedal and one foot on the other pedal.
Okay, Gord is a man.
Okay, now all you have to do is put your hands on the handlebars.
Put my hands on the handlebars. Uh-oh, I have a problem.
Well, what's the problem, Abby?
Well, I can only hold the handlebars with one hand because I'm holding my wand with this hand.
Oh, yeah, that is a problem.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I got it. I'll just put my wand in this hand.
Abby, no, I don't think that's still a problem.
Oh, you're right, because then I can still only hold the handlebars with one hand.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
yeah, but you know what, Abby?
Huh?
You could put down the wand while you're riding.
But where? I don't want my wand to be too far away.
Oh, wait, Abby. Mm-hmm. Elmo has an idea. Abby can put her wand in the basket.
In the basket?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, that's what the basket's for.
Wow, look at that. Okay, now try holding the handlebars, Abby. It worked. I can hold the handlebars with both hands now.
Yay!
Okay. And the handlebars steer. So if you want to go straight, hold the handlebar straight.
Straight.
That's right.
Straight.
And if you want to turn this way, turn the handlebars this way.
This way.
Right. And if you want to turn that way, turn the handlebars that way.
That way. Okay.
Right.
Sounds like Abby's ready to go.
Elmo, come back.
Elmo, no, come back, Elmo. Wait, Elmo.
What's wrong? What's wrong?
Well, I don't know how to do that yet.
Oh, yeah. Elmo forgot.
Show her, Gordon.
Yeah. Okay. Now, use your legs and your feet to push the pedals one at a time.
Okay.
Okay, try it.
Okay, one at a time.
No, it's not working. Gordon, this is frustrating. Maybe I should just use magic, huh?
No. You don't need magic. You just need to keep trying.
But I don't think I'll ever get it.
Sure you will. And I'll help you.
Really?
Yeah.
Gordon's the man.
Okay, I'm going to push you gently from behind, like this.
Okay. Oh, the pedals are moving. They're moving round and round and round and round. Oh, and I'm going forward. Yay, forward. And now I'm going even faster. Yay, faster. Oh, even faster. Gordon, I think you can let go now. Gordon already did, Abby. Oh, he did? Yeah.
Yeah, you're riding all by yourself, Abby. I may be the man, but it was Abby who did it.
Yeah. I did?
Sure. You didn't quit. You just kept at it And now you've learned to ride a tricycle.
Hey, yeah, I did.
So what are we waiting for? Let's ride, Abby.
Okay.
I go to you.
Okay.
I'm Judah, and I'm here to tell you about the word spectacular. See, the word spectacular is right there on my hat, and that means I'm spectacular because I'm wearing the hat. Now, when something is better than great, it's spectacular. Spectacular is amazing. Spectacular is fabulous. Spectacular is fantastic.
Whoa, Judah, that hat, it's amazing.
That hat is fabulous. That hat is fantastic. That hat is spectacular.
Yes, it is.
And you know what else is spectacular?
What?
You. You deserve it.
Huh?
Spectacular.
It's time for the letter M. That's why we're gonna play Bring Out Your M. What sound does the letter M make? That's good. Now, come on. Let's find some things that start with the letter M.
Bring out your M. Bring out your M.
Do you have anything that starts with the letter M?
Mustache.
Mustache. Yeah. Mustache starts with M. Bring out your M.
Money starts with M.
Money does start with M.
Okay.
Money.
Do you have anything here that maybe begins with the letter M?
Mom.
That's right. Mom begins with the letter M. Do you have anything that starts with the letter M? Ooh, I see something on you that starts with M. It's on your face, it's filled with teeth, and you eat with it. Know what it is? Yeah, mouth. Mouth begins with M. Magnificent. Now come on, let's see more of the letter M.
Hello there, Cookie Monster here. Me asking provocative question. What is letter of day? And we think letter of day in this cookie jar. Let's see. Could this be it? We take a chance. Whoa! Now, me wonder what letter of day could be. You know, it look to me like letter M. And let's see, go up, down, up, down. Yeah, feel like letter M and, smell like letter M and, yeah. Sound like letter M, but does it taste like letter M? Here we go. No. Letter of day on marvelous, magnificent cookie and me not supposed to eat cookie that has letter of day on it. But how am I going to stop myself from eating munchy-looking cookie? Me know. Me disguise this cookie so it not look like cookie anymore. It not look like cookie, then me not want to eat it. Oh, me so smart. Okay, and me happen to have, just by chance, cookie disguise here. Okay, let's put this on here. See if that works. Wait a minute. Where'd Cookie go? Cookie? Excuse me, sir. You know where Cookie went? Wait a minute. Wait a minute, you not sir. You Cookie. Oh, you imposter! Oh, well, case of mistaken identity. What is? Yuck.
You dump a bag of flour in some water. You mix it and you fix it with maybe an egg for a treat. You squeeze it out or roll it out, then slice it up or fold it. When you finish, what do you got? Lots of things to eat. Like spaghetti or a getty, portoletti and linguine. Some capelli or a nelly, vermicelli, farfalline. Rigatoni, macaroni, cannelloni, and stellini. Pappardelle, a rotelli, tagliatelle, fettuccine. Lasagna, tortellini. Before you cook the pasta in some water, you make a nice tomato sauce with maybe a little meat. You chop it and you mix it and you cook it and you taste it. You pour it on, what do you got? Healthy things to eat. Like spaghetti or a getty, portoletti and linguine. You will wish your arms were longer when you lift it to your face. That capelli or a nelly, vermicelli, farfalline. Try to slurp it, you'll get sauce all over the place. Rigatoni, macaroni, cannelloni, and stellini. You don't have to be Italian to enjoy your pasta treat. Pappardelle, aratelli, tagliatelle, fettuccine. You can start to learn the language just by saying things to eat. Rigatoni, macaroni, pappardelle, tagliatelle, pantaletti, orecchietti, vermicelli, a capelli, ziti, ziti, ravioli too. Pasta, pasta's very good for you. Hey!
Time for...
number three!
How many is three? One, two, three! Three jumps! Three babies! Let's count soccer juggles. One, two, three. Can you count to three?
One, two, three.
I really love the number three. Come on, let's check out more about the number three.
I can't wait to find out what the number of the day is either. But please control your enthusiasm. Go find a nice place to hang from so I can begin. There. Now, here we go. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
But first, listen up, because it's time for Sounds of the Street. Do you hear something? Can you guess what that sound is?
Garbage truck!
Great listening. Come on, let's listen some more. Oh, I hear something. What sound is that? Use your ears.
Wait, 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 wait.
What's that sound?
Wait, wait,
I have no idea.
Wait, wait, wait.
A penguin on a pogo stick.
Wait, wait,
wait. Oh, no. Now keep your eyes and ears open, because Elmo's world is coming soon.
Hi. You're just in time to see a great new trick I learned.
Yeah.
Abby's gonna make a flower come out of Rosita's ear.
See? Una flor.
Are you ready?
Ready!
Okay, here goes.
Can somebody get me out of here? This place ain't exactly roomy.
Oh, dear.
That's not a flower coming out of my ear, is it?
No, 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 no. I think it's a penguin.
Oh. Yeah, a very uncomfortable penguin. Little help.
What? Oh, yeah, here. Okay, we got it. Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
One.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Sesame Street. Mm-hmm. But I do not live on Sesame Street. You gotta poof me back home.
Oh, this penguin wants to go home.
Yes, mm-hmm. I know. Well, what do we do?
It looks like you have to find that habitat.
Huh? What's a habitat?
Mm-hmm. A habitat is a place where an animal lives.
Oh.
Where it lives is where it's at. We gotta find that animal's habitat.
Well, you heard the voice. We gotta find that penguin's habitat.
Yes, we do.
Well, a penguin is a bird. And I see lots of birds who live in nests in trees. So I think this penguin lives in a tree in the forest.
My turn.
I see lots of birds at the beach. Mm-hmm. So I think this penguin lives at the beach. Yeah.
Well,
I think penguins like snow and cold. So I think that this penguin lives in snowy, cold Antarctica. Mm-hmm.
Tree in the forest.
The beach.
Oh, Antarctica.
Would you guys just please decide already?
Where do you think this penguin lives?
Let's try the beach.
Okay, let's.
Okay.
your feet on the pedals and push.
That's the pedal.
Now push.
One foot on.
Now put your other foot on the pedal.
You can do it.
He's doing it.
Yeah, now pedal. Keep pedaling.
He's a little shaky.
Yay! That's great, Mr. Noodle.
Stop, Mr. Noodle.
You can stop now, Mr. Noodle.
He can't stop.
Does Mr. Noodle know how to stop?
Stop.
Uh-oh. Are you okay, Mr. Noodle?
I think the bike is broken.
Buddy wants to ask someone else. How do you ride a bike?
This is how I ride a tricycle. I pedal with my feet.
And now, Mama will ask a baby. Oh, hi, baby. Baby, how do you ride a bike? Oh, wow, look. Mama's watching you.
Street was brought to you today by the letter, I can't remember today's letter.
Let's rethink the day. Oh, there's the letter. What letter is it?
M.
Right. M is the letter of the day. But what's today's number? Oh, there it is. What's the number?
3.
Yes, 3 is the number of the day. So Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter M and by the number 3. This is Murray saying see you next time on the street. Peace.